Sunday. Coming to the end of the weekend. I was grateful. Got up this morning. The boys had slept the night away with their inflatable donuts around their necks and seemed quite content with them. They're out running around the backyard right now with these two big donuts around them. But it's so much better than those horrid cones. They can eat, they can drink, they can do whatever they want to do. They just can't, you know, lick their wounds here where those damn cones are like I said yesterday, the front of a skip loader. And they just bump into everything, every, you know, threshold on a door, every piece of gravel or anything just gets scooped up into those when you're as low as a basset hound. So really happy with these little inflatable donuts that have a nice fabric covering on them, so they're comfortable on them, and they just look so cute. It's just unbelievable how cute they look. Last night I did a bass part for a gentleman, Alberto, over in Italy, and sent it off this morning to him, and he's happy as can be to have this bass part on his album. He's a bass player. He's doing an album with all bass players joining him on his songs. We've been trying to get this together for ages and just haven't been able to. And finally I did it last night. I have a couple more projects to do for people. A few more books this morning, sorting all that stuff out. And then musically, I mentioned it yesterday, I'm gonna go back and a real fun project that we did. I did a lot of albums with Reba McIntyre over the years. I've known Reba since the very early parts of her career. And we did a number of albums down in Nashville. And we did this one that I'm taking these songs from out here at Capitol in the Big Room, Capitol Records Big Room, their Studio One. I always forget, is this 1, 2, 3 or ABC? It's the Big Room. Did Streisand there twice, lots and lots of different projects in that room. And Tony Brown was producing it with Reba. Tony I've known forever, did a lot of projects with him down in Nashville, but I knew him from back in the Emmylou Harris band days. He goes back to Elvis, playing with Elvis. Tony's wonderful producer, you know, wonderful, good friend. So the two of them produced it together. I think Steve Marcantonio engineered it. I can't remember on the actual dates, but I think it was Steve. But I put together some other notes about this project. On the tracks, I did 3 tracks on this album. And they did some tracks, other tracks back in Nashville. They used the A-Team cats down there. But on these tracks that I'm gonna do 3 songs here. I'm gonna play one, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and listen to the other two, because I had a minute and I just ran over this one tune. But it's myself and Russ Kunkel on drums, Tom Bukovac on guitar, who's got one of the best YouTube channels. If you haven't checked him out, go check him out. He's great. Matt Rawlings, the great Matt Rawlings, is on organ and piano on these tracks, and J.D. Manis is playing steel. J.D.'s a fabulous steel player. And this album was all duets. It's just Reba Duets is the name of the album. And we cut this in 2007. And there's the first song I'm going to do is Everyday People, and it's Reba and Carole King on that one. And then after that, I'll just go ahead and play When You Love Someone, which is Reba and Leanne Rimes. And I had the pleasure of doing one of Leanne Rimes' albums. Maybe I'll go visit that next or somewhere in there. And then the other one is Break Each Other's Hearts, which is Reba and Don Henley. And hopefully Don won't get this thing bumped off of YouTube, but it's Reba's project and not his, so I don't think this will be a problem. The fun thing was when we did the day with Carol, you get so used to coming in the studio and it's like nothing but like donuts and junk food and all kinds of crap in there. once in a while you'll get into the really healthy department and they'll order some bagels and cream cheese and maybe even some lox. But man, when I came into the Carol's date, there was a platter that was probably, you know, this big, sitting there in the area just outside the studio, that had the best assortment of every kind of olive, pickle, any of that stuff that you could imagine. It was the most beautiful platter. And man, I just turned into like just the grazing fiend, because I love pickles, I love olives, I love all that stuff. And it was just this, one of the most beautiful assortments I've ever seen. So that it's hard when you come away from a project and you've made all this great music, but the thing you really remember is the olive and pickle platter. But it was something to behold and something to behold in. Didn't hold it for long because that stuff goes through you. I remember driving once over, I think it's Highway 156, Pacheco Pass. It goes between Highway 1 and 101 here in Central California. And it was cherry season. And there's a place called Casa de Fruta that started off as just a little fruit stand on this pass. And it's turned into like Disneyland. I mean, it's like hotel and petting zoo and all, I mean, you name it, all kinds of touristy stuff. But in the old days, it was just this fabulous fruit stand. And I remember my wife and I, we were driving over that pass and it was cherry season. And man, they had a tub, about a 4-pound tub of the most exquisite sweet cherries imaginable. And we both just sat there as we're driving towards Highway 1, 101 from 1. We've just got this thing sitting on the front seat, just chowing down and popping the seeds out the window and everything. By the time we got to 101, we could not find a gas station quick enough. We could almost hear our stomachs grinding away with all this fresh cherry in us. I mean, it was one of those things, is like the old story I had told about being in Belgium in the president's train and finding the car with all the eclairs in it and just eating myself into a flatline coma. Well, that's what this was. And then with this Reba date, finding those olives was just unbelievable. So I'm going to do this song, Everyday People, and this is Reba and Carole King on this. I'll play along with this one, and then I'm just going to listen to the other two along with you. So here we go. Let me see if I can get through this one. Oh, wish me luck.
Miracles, and it's beautiful. It's a fact. In the new...
Tried to get it off before that. Everyday People. And that's Carole King and Reba in duet form. This song is Break Each Other's Hearts Again, and this is Reba and Don Henley. I'm going to check one thing and see if this thing... Oh, good, it's still there. I can never tell when I've set something up. Sometimes just a cough, and all of a sudden the whole screen's gone and stuff. So here we go. This is the same band, same everything here, just different, different duet. So here we go. For J.D. Manis, is such a beautiful... Oh, please, they're going to, what, put a commercial? Oh, okay. I hate that crap. Hold on just a minute. I'm going to start it over now with that interruption. Don's voice, you know, it's always been, man, just like one of those signature voices where you go, man, this guy's got just beautiful. Remember, I think we were doing Rick Roberts's album. I said it before, but Don and I were working on that. You know, it's before the Eagles hit, and I remember him just, we were talking, and he said, "You think Eagles is a stupid name for a band. And then I looked at him, I said, I thought the Beatles was a stupid name for a band. It's like the first time I heard the Beatles, I mean, the first thing I thought of was insects. You know, but, you know, if you have a great band and you make great music, the name will come along for the ride. So that's not a big deal. You just got to make great music and then people will, you know, forget about maybe how really silly the name was. Eagles isn't really a silly name by any means, but it's just funny thinking back to pre-time. Then I'm going to do, the last song I'm going to do is When You Love Someone Like That. And this is Reba and Leanne Rimes. And I really had a great time in the studio with Leanne. She's really a good artist, really a fun person to work with. I'll have to go try and dig that one up again, too. I've been looking at all these things I worked on, trying to find them. Some of the stuff's just really hard to find. I was looking at some Ricky Martin and some Enrique Iglesias and El Vivo. There's a whole bunch of stuff like that. Pepe Aguilar. I'm going to try to find some more of that kind of stuff. Tired. You know, I've been anxious with the pups and stuff, so not sleeping that well. But let me go ahead and play this one. So this is Reba and Leanne Rimes together here. There we go. And this is still the same bunch of musicians.
Too much.
First off, their voices really go together. It's really hard to tell sometimes who's singing what, why they really blend. One of the great things is when you're in the studio with the band and the artists, it makes making music so much easier when everybody's there. And I love projects like that. I've done so many projects where the artist isn't there and we're just anticipating what they're going to do, guessing. So when you've really got them, it's a whole lot better. So that was Reba and Duets. And I'm going to find some more goodies for tomorrow. But I was going to ask one thing, too, for any of you who haven't done it. If you would be so kind as to go to the immediate family YouTube channel and subscribe. We're working really hard on building it and adding content. Constantly to it. So indulge me. And if you do, it doesn't cost anything. It's cheap for what it is, I'll tell you that. But it would be fun just to have everybody coming over there and checking out what we're up to. We're just so anxious to really get going. We got a bunch of stuff that we're working on right now, and it'll be up before too long. And like that, so I'd really just say thank you in advance to anybody that goes over and does that. It's much appreciated. I'm going to get jamming now and figure out what the rest of the day holds. I might go out. It poured yesterday. It's beautiful and clear today, so I might go out and do a little more yard work today because we're supposed to have most of next week is supposed to be rain. Might have one day break, but we need this so bad. So I figure I'll just take advantage of the few things that I've got to do. Let me see. Oh, it's a little windy out there. That's good. A little breeze going on. I can see my jacaranda tree just flowing beautifully out there. So, okay, I digress. I look out the window and I'm suddenly in my head just drifts out to projects. Take good care. Have a really great rest of the weekend, or for those of you that are starting yours or ending it. Just take good care. Stay safe. Please stay safe. I'm counting the moments till Tuesday when I can go get my first Moderna shot. I'm really looking forward to that and get that ball rolling. So, and my heart's with everybody out there again who didn't have a weekend because they're working in the hospitals, in the medical field, and people that are prepping for next week, all the people at, you know, teachers, people at the market, trash people, postal people. There's so many jobs where people are in harm's way, so we need to respect them and thank them for their diligence through this horrible period. And I will see you guys and gals tomorrow morning, and I'll be back. As I've said before, I'm like gum on your shoe. You think you've cleared me off, and then you walk in the house, and there I'm in the carpet. And that here out comes the ice cubes and peanut butter and every other old wives' tale about how you get a bass player, gum out of your carpet. So, okie dokie, you take good care, and I will talk to you later. Okay, bye-bye.